Hi Lootbacks. Today we're talking about the rewards you can get in World vs. World. This includes the immediate rewards from fighting, but also the more passive rewards like reward tracks and pips. The most basic rewards are the ones you'll be getting as long as you're actively playing. The most common reward you'll find in World vs. World is heavy loot bags. These represent you killing an enemy. Do note you will not be getting one for every kill, but more like every third or fourth kill. Besides the heavy loot bags, you can also get other variations of the loot bags, but these are much more rare, and the contents are not necessarily better. Whether you want to open or sell your loot bags is up to you. I personally prefer to open them and save the materials for a rainy day. As you're killing people, you will also be looting some unidentified gear of different rarities. You'll not be getting this as much as in PvE maps, but it adds a nice little extra income. Next up is reward tracks. These are similar to the ones you'll find in structured PvP. Reward tracks are what they sound like. They put you on a track for some reward. The way it works is that you pick the track you want. Different ones give you different rewards along the way, and over time, as you're playing, you'll passively gain those rewards. To find the World vs. World reward tracks, click B on your keyboard and click the Reward Track tab. Here you can browse the reward tracks and get an overview of their rewards. To choose a reward track, click the Activate button. You can also set it to repeat if you want to keep doing the same reward track over and over. There are two major types of reward tracks, repeatable and non-repeatable. As you're starting out, going through all the non-repeatable ones will generally help you maximize out your rewards up front, especially because non-repeatable tracks give you 7 Mystic Clovers by the end, which can help you speed up crafting legendary items. Do note that some reward tracks you have to unlock. This can be everything from doing the story mode for a dungeon to completing a Living World episode. During festivals, you'll also find limited time tracks with festival-specific rewards. To maximize your reward tracks, you should be trying to get your participation up to tier 6. In order to get a higher participation, you want to kill enemies, flip sentries, camps, towers, or keeps. In general, play the game mode and you'll get there in no time. This will give you the most progress on the reward track every 5 minutes. At tier 6, without any boosters, it'll take you about 8.5 hours to complete. At the end of each reward track is a bigger reward. This is commonly some skins or some rare materials. Pips are another type of passive rewards you get for simply playing. Compared to reward tracks, pips will get reset once every week and you have to start over. You also do not progress it by your participation alone. In order to progress it every 5 minutes, you simply have to have a participation over tier 3. How much you're progressing on your pips every tick is determined by different factors. Depending on how your world is doing in the current skirmish, you'll get 3, 4, or 5 pips based on the current skirmish placement. You'll get everything from 0 to 7 pips based on your rank. You'll get 1 extra pip for commanding a squad of at least 5 other people. You'll get 3 additional pips for commanding a public squad with at least 10 people. If you manage to get the wood pip chest the previous week, you'll get 1 extra pip this week. You'll also get 5 additional pips if you're currently outnumbered on your map. Getting pips will progress you through different chests, from wood to diamond, with the diamond being repeatable. To finish each chest, you have to get a certain amount of pips, and along the way you get check marks that will give you some smaller rewards. These rewards are commonly memories of battle, skirmish claim tickets, and boosts to your reward track progress. To check your current progress of your pips, you can click B on your keyboard and go to the Match Overview tab. Then you can see it in the bottom. The reason to care about your pips and getting through the chests each week are World vs. World skirmish claim tickets. These are the currency you use to buy the endgame rewards in World vs. World. Endgame rewards like unique World vs. World skins, legendary armor, and the legendary trinket Conflux. The maximum amount of World vs. World skirmish claim tickets you can get in a week is 365. To compare this to a full set of legendary armor, we need to get at least 7,880 skirmish claim tickets it would take you 22 weeks to finish the set. I hope this helped you get a better overview of the different types of rewards you can get when you're playing World vs. World. As always, if you like the video, click the thumbs up, and if you dislike it, click the thumbs down. If you have any questions, throw them my way over on Discord, in a comment below, or on Twitter. Links are in the description. Also, make sure to check me out on Twitch, twitch.tv/reddish.